Operational report. Contact report. Submarines detected. Liberator lost. Repairs complete. Contact report. Contact report. Contact report. Kill credit. Kill credit. Kill credit. Kill credit. More kill credits. Recon over Kobe. Double recon. Looks like that's the only recon we get. Sargo's been hit. Uh-oh. Trigger's been hit. Uh-oh. Contact report. Contact report. No. How come I'm not hitting his submarines? Damn it. Recon over Oita. I'm doing this because we might decide to bombard in the near future. Trying to get that detection level up. Recon. Recon. We're dropping the parachute assault on Matsuyama. Repairs complete. Captured. Expansion. Upgrade begins. Repairs complete. Reinforcement. Alameda, Calcutta, Baikin. Well, don't worry about Baikin, but Alameda. Oh, this is just a transfer at Calcutta. Transfer at Calcutta. Taking a quick look. Aircraft losses for the day. We'll just take a look at our aircraft. Wow, another 23. Wildcats gone. 19 to air. Wow. One Liberator from a bombing mission. We destroyed 163 aircraft, but we also lost 52 in the process. That's not a good exchange rate. At Hong Kong, we had two submarines coming out. I guess I forgot to launch them last turn. Talk too much, do too little. Send them into the gauntlet. Here comes a S-40 coming to Hong Kong. At Shanghai, we have four submarines in. Whoa! Both in. Nicely done. Severely damaged. Make sure we refuel and rearm. That's important. Rearm as well. Bowfin, none of them are due for upgrade, so we'll take the Bowfin. Wow. Set her into the shipyard. Scamp, as well as Grunion. We'll just fix them up in the readiness. Poji, going back out to Shikoku Station. No enemy activity over Suitao, Amoy, or Fuchao. Looks like the center is quiet. No enemy activity over Shanghai. Shanghai, I've got the martlets in. I'm going to use the martlets to patrol range of one. I think they're at 10,000. It doesn't really matter. There hasn't been any real combat here for a while. Oh, these guys are. They had these guys down low. We're going to order the Mustangs to rest. The Warhawks are already resting. I'm going to bring some of these infantry units. I'm sending them over to Fusan, so that we can airlift them for here. Oops, not these guys. You know, some of these guys aren't such a bad idea. Well. Except that they're going to be leaving very soon. I'm trying to march them off. You know what? Most of this stuff can be carried by aircraft. So, I'm thinking about sending them over to Fusan. And the only thing I can't go are the trucks. The final few units of trucks. But we can send those later. if they're going to be destroyed anyway, this is mostly an infantry formation. I can send them over as garrison units because they're already purchased. I don't have to worry about I don't have to worry about spending political points. And this one's going to be wiped or gone in 440 days anyway. I'll think about that. Over on Korea, the Chinese army has just marched off into the wilderness here. It's 16,000 assault value. Can you believe that? And I will march them all the way to India because they have no more function on. They can't. There's nothing to conquer. May as well let them garrison India as there's nothing to do here. They can't attack. All right, just for simply, I'm going to set all of them for Tokyo anyway. Not that we're ever going to get off the island unless somebody builds a bridge we can walk across. So we've got them here. I'm hoping that the AI will take the opportunity to spot and bomb them. To sweeten the deal, this is the headquarters that we just used to help with Matsuyama. See, Matsuyama, the combat, we can see at the bottom here. This is the assault. The different combat modifiers, we had the shock from parachute assault. We also had a leadership modifier. I don't know what the leadership modifier is. Was this the headquarters from the army headquarters or not? We also we passed the leadership test. We failed the leadership test, and we had some disruption. God only knows how. Well, maybe that's the disruption we already had after the attack on Kochi. Anyway, so I don't know which one of these leadership actually helped. It doesn't really matter, Matsuyama. Whether it helped or it didn't, it's done. We have no other targets available. We already have a headquarters assigned to every target, every city within range. So I don't even have a new target. Well, I guess we could. Let's go for Tsushima, right? Tsushima has a base fortress. I wasn't intending on capturing it, but hey, we might as well aim for something better than nothing. Nonetheless, I'm going to march this guy up here. I'm hoping that with the army guys, and the AI seems to like to bomb headquarters, priority. If he can detect the headquarters, let him bomb it! To help protect these guys, I'm going to move. I have an anti-aircraft artillery unit moving over. Now, I don't normally like to waste units like this because this one can be shipped over to Japan. But for now, I'm going to do it. I'm going to use it. To protect these guys, these are all my Soviet fighters. I'm going to be setting these guys on range. They're very short range anyway. I'm going to set them up for a range of 2. I will drop this down. Let's see if we can't keep it consistent. We'll set all the I-53s for this. We'll even set some for 10,000 and higher. So I want to keep this sustainable. I want to fly it at range. We have hundreds. We have 1,000 Soviet fighters, if you can believe that. So I'm keeping most of these biplanes, the I-153s, down low. I will use the I-16s to fly a little bit higher, and the one I-15, these guys are going to stay low as well. Oops, they only have a very, very short range. So we'll set all the 15s. Yeah, we'll just keep all of these guys nice and down low. We'll have the I-16s fly a little bit higher, but we have so many of the damn things. So many. We'll even keep a few of them up right high. But the fact is, they'll be flying. Oops. Range 2. So they should be able to cover the army guys. These guys are still flying long range, but they're flying range 5, so they're roving all over the countryside at 11 and 13 fatigue. They can keep this up forever. Then that's the whole point. Keep it up forever. These other ones are already at 8. They were flying just over their own base, and they were getting level 8 fatigue already. So hopefully by 50% flying at range of 2, they will be able to reduce that fatigue. Over at Fusan, we have Recon. Oh, let's take a look. The Recon efforts. Oh, come on. How hard is it to find Recon? We had Recon going up. We checked out Oita, or Kobe, with these guys. They are a little bit tired now. Bring them back down to rest. Let's set all the Recon down to rest. The Wildcats, I think, are at level 2. I think I'm going to bring them down to rest as well. We have these F4s are ready to go. Send them down for Kobe. We want to hit it again. The other ones are going to recover. I had these guys flying Oita in preparation of some bombardment missions. I'm not going to do that right now because the battleships just aren't ready yet, so we'll wait for a little while longer. Instead, I'm going to take another recon. I'm going to take these shorter ranged ones, the F5 Lightnings, F5 Alphas. They only have a range of 6. Let's see, can we get Uleundo. Let's see if there's anything out here, whether we can take it by parachute assault. If it's unoccupied, we'll send the parachutists after it, and it's within range of 5 for us. Good. Long range. I've brought in the Navy Liberators. I brought in the Mitchells. I brought in pretty much everything. I left one Navy recon squadron at Saipan, I think. Or in the Marianas, just in case. Everything else is flying out of here. We just don't need them in the south, and I might need them here. Look, just the ferry flight over raised their fatigue level. That's just one flight. So I have to use these guys quite sparingly. They're quite brittle. They fly once every 4 days, whereas the F4 Lightnings can fly every second day. Bomber-wise, let's go. We have the bombers did well. They went out. They did their thing. The fortresses, they hit. I'm going to shut them all down, rest all the liberators and whatnot. So we'll set all night, all level bombers. But these guys, the Delta ones, are recovered. So we're sending them after Kobe. Let's hit the port. Yep, all the Delta ones. Anybody else going with us? Let's see. Oh, yeah, these guys can go. Hold on. Let's say Kobe. Select. Kobe. Right. Everybody, set all the level bombers. And now I will go back and I'll just turn these guys off. Set all the Delta ones. So they're going to bomb. We can go down to the Liberators here. It's already set for Kobe. Okay, turn it off. Turn off the rest part. Let them bomb. Turn off the Ventura. Let them bomb. The Mitchells. Ooh, you know, the Delta ones don't have a lot of support. Sure, we'll send the Mitchells with them. They're within range. It's within the 11 range, normal range. So that's fine. The English Liberators we're going to hold because they're slightly tired. Fighter sweeps. We have the same. Look at these. Oh, sorry. Take out the Soviets. These guys, look at, they're still recovering from that one-day fighter sweep they had. Wow. All the way down, long-range combat air patrol. But these P-38 Gulfs, they're tired. They have a fatigue level 4. Let's keep them fresh. Who do we want to sweep? Well, we'll sweep Kagoshima for sure. We'll use the... We didn't get any action yesterday, but we have these smaller squadron, the Foxtrots. Okay. Send them for Kagoshima. I don't expect a hell of a lot, but these are less capable fighters too. We just captured Matsuyama. Matsuyama has little damage. I'll set to expand, but they don't have any engineers down there. We have all we have at the base are just a few parachutists left. They are enough sufficient for the garrison for the moment, so I'll leave them. I'm going to leave them as is. What they need support right away because the AI likes to bomb undefended bases. So I am going to send the fighters. I've got Warhawks from Qinhai. Okay, we'll send them over. Matsuyama. I will divide them. So we're going to fly at 20, at 15, and 10. What the hell? Oh. One at 15 and one flight at 10,000. We also have, I'm going to bring the Shanghai kilos over. They're not, we don't have as many. I wish I had 20, I need 25. The base can hold 50 aircraft on there. So I may as well put the full 50 in if I can find another 25 fighters. Yeah, I don't want to send... The Lightnings are just too light. Have I run out of fighter squadrons? That's just... I hate to say it, but even the Americans can run out of fighter squadrons. Yep, they can. Okay, so I've run out of fighter squadrons. I'm going to put these 40 kilos in. No, we can't put these 40 kilos because we can't get them over. God almighty. Can you believe that? Yep, can't. Got a trans. We can't get drop tanks here because we don't have enough freaking supply. All right. So we transfer over to... where is that? Fusan. We transfer over to Fusan. We'll go next turn. All right, looking at how bad the situation is on Matsuyama, I want to get 50 fighters over here. It looks like I'm going to... I'll send the... Yeah. It's not my favorite. But I will send the hotels. Matsuyama. These guys are the best flying at high altitude, so we're going to put them at combat air patrol. High altitude, range of 0. That means I can bring down this flight, these Warhawks. Okay, we don't need to fly them at 20. We'll fly them at 5. We have the hotel, the P-38 Lightnings, flying top cover. I will tell you, you got to fly some at night. If you don't fly them at night, these guys, you'll get bombed. So instead of flying at 5,000, we'll fly night mission. Keep the enemy from getting smart on us. We have no aviation support here. So I've got the transports moving in. The commandos are going to drop in an RAF base force. This one RAF base force isn't very much that's air transportable, but at least it'll bring some engineers. So those little hits that on the airfield, we can try to repair some of those. We're also going to send over the Skytrains are sending in the 171st Wing. The 171st Wing has 75 aviation support. That's plenty of aviation support, but it also has this darned observer corps, as I might have seen earlier. We can't move this thing by air. I normally don't like to send in units piecemeal like this, but I will send it for now as a temporary measure until we can get some ships to drop over the observer corps. We need something to hold the base, to hold and protect the base until they can link up with the units from Kochi. But the enemy, if we can't get out of here and they can't get in, so it's not a big concern for me. We're not going to be attacked by land. On the air bases, we can see that even though it's only a level 2, level 1 air base, we can hold up to stack up to 6 because this is now under the jurisdiction of Southeast Asia. The air headquarters here, Southeast Asia, we have an air headquarters, 10th Air Force, is Air East Asia, and it has a command radius of 5. So they share the same command radius. So up to here, we can the command influence from the headquarters unit will allow us to stack an extra additional 5 units. Here, it's up to 7. Our Warhawks are fighting hard, and I'm bringing in reinforcements to these guys already. We're keeping them off us at night. Unfortunately, now look here. We unloaded last turn, and that's we unloaded a whole crap load of supply, right? Not as much as I'd hoped, but hey, it's better than nothing. We now have 1,500 aviation support here. Wow! We won't use, but that's going to be used spread up among bases all along here as we conquer them, hopefully. Now the units on the ground, they've all come off at strategic mode, and I will now put them in. Ooh, these are still unloading. See, they're still unloading from 385. That's good. But now we're going to put everybody into combat mode. This will get them moving. I think what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take the head. I'm going to take all the infantry and the armor, and any artillery. No, none of the artillery arrived. I will also be moving the combat engineers. No, not the headquarters unit. So everybody here. Okay, let's start that again. We'll take the infantry, armor, and some of the combat engineers. We're going to set everybody into movement mode. Set all, and we're going to start marching on Takamatsu. Set all to march. I'm not too worried because these guys are still going to be unloading, so the rest of their units will arrive. Not a big deal. Now we have to sort all these other ones. The headquarters units, we're going to drop into. These are all air headquarters, so it doesn't really matter for them. We'll set all of them to strategic mode. That will cancel their movement order. I will. That'll put them back into strategic mode. Is it better to leave them in? It doesn't matter. Whatever mode we leave them in, their air aviation support is still functional, so that'll be fine. Now we have to take the armor is moving. Now armor moves very quickly, so I'm going to put armor in. I'll put it in reserve mode so that it marches very slowly. This way it'll march at about the same rate as the infantry divisions. Otherwise, these guys just race right ahead and get to places much too early. They don't have enough combat power to actually take bases, so that's why I don't want them arriving too early, or else they get wasted bashing their heads against defenses. Engineer-wise, we do want the engineers moving, but we don't want the base forces moving. These guys down here, these are your naval support. You don't want those guys moving. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the engineers. We're going to set them all back into strategic mode. Drop them back into combat mode, and now I want them to move the combat engineers. I'll move them individually, set them in movement mode. Actually, I'm just going to leave them in combat mode. Hopefully, they aren't going to unpack for a couple of days. So in the 2 days here, I hope that they will help us build the base. Once they come out of combat mode, then I'll change them to movement mode and move them onwards. So we've got 1,500 engineers here. Along with this is a 5 times, that's another 1,200 engineer equivalent squads. So right now on the base we have approximately 27, 2,800 engineers. Can you believe that? This is just gonna skyrocket. Also, with all the naval support coming down, 163, that's gonna help this We only unloaded 16,000 or so here. But now with these ships unloading, it's going to go like crazy. These guys, these are regular transports. These are not as well. These are no. These assault transports didn't unload very quickly either. That's dummies. So these, we should be able to get them down. That's all. Overall, there should be about 800,000 supplies here, approximately. Some of it's in the base in the form of half a million is in the form of the AKEs, the replenishment ship. We don't want to touch those. So this is 230. This is 330. 4, 5, 6, 7, 750,000 approximately. I'd say 750,000 in supplies. Three quarters of a million. All right, now I want to talk about my sh the ships here. Ah, I lost an AO here. I was trying to unload the damn thing so that we could get the fuel into the base. This left because I'm docked at the I was docked until we popped loose trying to evade the attack. I was docked here, and that cost me the AO because the AI was able to attack and put a torpedo into it. Bastard. One torpedo, AO, gone. Up in flames. But we did manage to unload this other AO here. The other tank, the other oiler. Now, what bugs me is, I'm just trying to get the fuel into the base so that we can take these AOs out. I didn't have to. I could have just left the AOs in the base. And we would have sucked the fuel out of them just fine, just as they are right now. See, these are they're having the fuel taken right out of them. But it doesn't get the fuel in. I can't take the tankers out of here in order to unload them in order to go back and get some more. So the question is, should I really, I lost a tanker the first day doing it. Should I try it again? Get more fuel into the base. You know, when they suck fuel from the base, they're not only sucking from the tankers, they're also sucking from the base. So just because I unload the fuel into the base, the AI is just as likely to suck the fuel out of the base rather than the AOs, which is not a good thing. It doesn't make me happy. Do I risk another AO for I'd say dubious tactical advantage? See, I could put it back up here. Ah, hell. They're only worth 19 points. I'm so callous with these guys. No, I'm gonna see if I can't unload some more. That way I can pull out these AOs afterwards when the fleet retreats. I could wait until we build us up a little bit higher. I have a few more fighters on here. I'm going to take that as a just the enemy got a lucky bomb hit, lucky torpedo hit. I'm going to try to unload the rest of them. So maybe I'm just being stupid. Ship-wise, we have okay, we'll take the AOs and auxiliary out. We have the minesweepers all in. They've all refueled. I have dropped in the here's the battleship bombardment groups. What these are the battleships I'm leaving behind. I'm going to leave the British. These are the British destroyers. The British destroyers are here. I think they have British and Australian destroyers. They have quite a bit of experience with these bomb runs, and they're pretty dedicated. So I think I'm going to leave just because they're already deployed or disbanded into the base. I'm going to leave these guys behind. They don't have a very long range. I was doubtful of even using them up here, but because they don't have a very long range, they're ideal for little short run blasting missions, bombardment missions. So I think I'll leave the Dutch, a mixture of Dutch, Australian, and British destroyers to escort the bombardment ships. So right now I will, okay. Let's switch up. We're going to take the AOs, we're going to undock, we're going to take these out of here. I want to suck these guys dry for fuel first. So what I will do is I'm going to take the AOs, the ones that are full of fuel, these big ones, out of the base. Let's see. There's one here that's These are they're down to 25%. Let's take the base guys. Okay, we'll take the units on the base. First, we'll take the battleships. Let them drink first. Hopefully, this will suck from the AOs. Now we'll check the against the against. These are all filled up. Let's see, how are the AOs doing? We used up. Oh, see, no, it sucked us. It sucked from the base. Bastards, stupid bastards. We'll have the escorts. Let's see, let's refuel these guys. Check against the AO. The base is pretty much sucked dry, but we still have the AOs have been touched right here. They took 900 out of this one. Okay. Mine vessels are already loaded. Let's see, cruisers. Let's load the cruisers. Whoa, the cruisers sure drank a lot there. They oh, okay, so we've sucked the cruisers dry. This AO is empty. This one's at 350. What, sorry, not empty, but used up. And let's see, anybody else? Carrier? I am not going to leave a carrier here because the bombardment groups should be able to come in and out and be back safely at the base under air cover before the next day's bombardment. So we don't need to send air cover with them. Cruisers, okay, we had any DEs? AP, no, not the AOs. So we're making sure we only fuel the ones that we absolutely must fuel. All right, so we still have some fuel left on this one. 651 points that we or operational points to use out of this one. Let's see, I'm going to leave a few APDs around here. I've been using them to move these surface detachments, but I don't think they're gonna. I'm not making any other runs anywhere else, so I don't need to do anything else. But I will. So I'll leave a few here just in case. We'll form up a fast transport. We'll use the APDs. I'm gonna take the ones with the lowest, the slowest, lowest and slowest, the least amount, least. They're empty already. Okay, I'll leave 1, 2, 3, 4, right? These are the Wix class. Yeah, they're my just in case ones. I'll disband these. So now we have APDs in the port. Let's reload. Are these my slowest ones? I hope these are. Check the AOs again. We sucked another 300 or so out of here. I'll refuel a few more of these APDs, but I think I'm going to take them back. Just they can load little things like air aviation units and whatnot, so I'm not really. I can still use them. I can still use them. But I'll have a couple here just in case I have to shift a few units around or go on raids with them. On the base, oh yes, I noticed that we are all aimed for Kochi. Well, we're already down on Kochi. We don't need it. The next base, I know I've assigned the Australians to take over Hiroshima, but they aren't here. We are, so we may have to do the fighting for Hiroshima ourselves. I was going to plan for them to take on Nagasaki, but we might not be able to take Hiroshima without the additional planning points. So I'm gonna focus everybody on Hiroshima. Yeah, we might have to take them. We also have, I managed to get in the, let's see, where is that now? One of the, hold on, where did it go? Ah, yes, the Santee dropped in under escort. It was an escort group, dropped in and automatically dropped into repair mode because it's so badly damaged. All right, we're going to change Santee. We're going to give it a critical rating. Look at all the ships under repair. Critical, and it's under pier side. I could put it under repair ship, but I'm trying to get the battleships off on the repair ships first. And right now, Santee has so many other things that are broken. We'll let her fix the other stuff like system and some of the flotation before we let her, the repair ship, get at the other stuff. Dorsetshire is also on, oh, let's put him on high. Let's fix what we can, and maybe we'll send it off to the repair ship. Let's get into the pier side so we can pump out. Hopkins. Now these guys are doing the best they can. We don't worry about the AKE. It'll be here for a long, long time. The destroyers, the Sovereign. Okay, we'll get all these guys into repair as well. Oh gosh. Sorry, it just takes so long. I'm clicking on it and it's just waiting. Ka-chunk, ka-chunk. Click. 1, 2, 3. Click. 1,002. Click. 1,002. 1,003. Sorry. Just trying to set these into high priority. Here's the APD. Alright, so Santee is under critical. Dorset and everyone else is just going to pump a little water. Newcastle, yeah, it can sail, it can fight as is. I just want to send them out in the best condition possible. Alright, now we also have the ships under repair. The Santee is also holding a couple of carrier or air groups that. So we're going to transfer these to the base. Santee is pretty much done for the next time being. At least if we get these onto the base, the aircraft can recover. We can rejoin them and send them off to fight somewhere else or fight from the land. Either one. Either one is good for us. So my two AOs have been pretty much drained until I can get the base a little bit stronger. I'm going to keep them out of harm's way. I'm not going to unload it because the AI sucks from the base and then sucks from the AO anyway. So it's the AI ships refueling, suck the base dry before they get a chance. So why bother? Why risk the AOs when the end result is they suck it right out of the base before they start sucking from the AOs? So I'll let them suck directly from the AOs. Hopefully, if we can drain these last two, I don't want to, but if I need to, I'll drain these last two, and then we can send them back with the returning transports. Anybody want to take a bet how long it takes to unload all this stuff? I say 2 days. I bet you it'll be 2 days, and we'll have this all unloaded. The carrier has retreated back here. We haven't taken any hits, any attacks even. We're just sitting back here. We're in good shape. We're not taking any additional leaks. Waiting for these guys to unload. I could still run over to drop ships off at Shanghai and use the port there, but I only have 3 really damaged ships, 2 battleship and a light carrier. For that reason, it's not worth the effort. This should be a modest, not a heavy load for Pearl Harbor. This ship is 28,000 tons. This battleship is 37,000 tons, so what's that, 65,000 tons? That's about two-thirds of Pearl Harbor's capability. It shouldn't be overly taxing. The lack of squadrons to go in to protect Matsuyama, it's a good wake-up call. Good wake-up call. I have these tired 38 Foxes. They are at 15 fatigue, so I can't be using them for a little while. You know what? Because they have 25 fighters here. These are important. I'm going to upgrade these guys. Or not upgrade. Yeah, I'll call them an upgrade. I'm going to upgrade them to P-47 Deltas. Why? Because here, the Delta 2s, look at this. This is a service rating of 1. These guys can fly every damn day. And they're tough. So we're going to do it. We're going to upgrade the Foxtrots that we can barely use to something that we can actually use. I'm going to try to use up all these spares as well. all the reserves. So when we send these guys in, they'll dominate that battlefield. Which means I'm going to take out some of these guys down here. These guys have been on, okay, they've been resting. So these Thunderbolts are ready to go. Strap on tanks. Let's transfer over to Fusan. Rest, and we'll throw you back in the war. These other Thunderbolts, the Warhawks here, are recovering. I'm going to bring in more short-range fighters over here, probably Echoes, something to cover the base, but something that will allow these guys to do their thing. We need them engaged in... There we are. So we're going to allow these guys to slow down. We have one squadron of Thunderbolts up at night and another one covering. So I'll bring another. Let's see. What have we got here? Escort sweep. Okay. I'll bring the shorter ranged Echoes in. Ewo. We'll put them right into the put them right up in combat air patrol. Okay, where are they? 24. Yes. Well, oops. We'll break these guys down. We'll have some one fly at 5, one fly at 10, and one at 15. We'll slowly move out the Thunderbolts. They are much more effective in over Japan. And there's the AI. I don't think anything can reach out here. We can't reach him. So how the hell is the AI going to reach us? The bombers can come from Yokohama. Yeah, they could get out here. So I do have to keep some point defense fighters on here, but they're not going to reach down to Pagan. I could probably bring up some of these Hurricanes or Corsairs or some Wildcats to cover as I move the P-40 Echoes in. The big thing is these are 25 plane squadrons, and I want those 25 plane squadrons in over a base. The size matters. So I'm going to be shuffling in some more of these Hurricane squadrons to cover the little bases, the point defense bases. I will up these Warhawks here. They're, again, this is a P-40 Bravo. I've been using them in the background because they've been point defense, but now because they can carry 25 fighters, I'm going to want them up over in Japan. As soon as I can get some of these smaller squadrons like the Martlets up, this one's already over. Do I have any Hurricanes? I'm looking for Hurricanes. Here we are, Hurricanes. We're resting them. I'll be bringing more over to relieve these. I could even pull out everything from Keijo. I don't need Keijo. I don't need Chinhae. Near Taiwan, we have gone over the 4,100, so we're entering the attack again. The group army, I've dropped them into reserve so that we can keep moving without hopefully interfering with their retreat out of here. More units coming across from reinforcements, more construction regiment from Wuchang, and air support wings, as well as anti-aircraft artillery. Yes, we're gathering Hurricane here, letting it rest. Yeah, all these big... Okay, here's a squadron of 12 only. That's good. Point defense. No, I want the big 25s. If I can relieve the big 20 squadrons of 25, they make a bigger impact in Japan. Units moving past, Kowloon Brigade coming. No new arrivals in Bangkok. Okay, we're going to pull out. These guys are overstacked anyway. So I'm going to... Which one's the weakest one? This one. He lacks the most aircraft. Let's see. 20 pilots. He had another one killed the other day. So we will request... Wow. Look at all those pilots in the 80s. The lowest is a 66. Can you believe that? Okay. We'll put them on rest. Oh, come on. Oh yeah, we need the tanks just to get up to Bangkok. Okay, so we've got 7 here now. Now we'll pull out, I'm going to pull one out of Kota Baru as well. It's a shame I got to leave these P-40 kilos here, but the enemy, every so often he attacks, and without P-40 kilos to help, I think it's too much for the Hurricanes. Alright, this one needs drop tanks as well. Oh, for God. Bangkok, there we go. So make sure that these guys who, when we pulled out, make sure somebody's still flying top cover. 20,000, good. Make sure the same thing here. We pulled them out, they were flying top cover. 20,000, good. There's still a squadron here. Let's make sure we maximize our replacements. Yeah, we've still got plenty of one. We've got the Canadians with their 30. So we could probably pull out another squadron here too. Let's see, which one's the... Ah. Okay. Another one goes to Bangkok. Let's make sure we have the gaps covered here. Oh, he's up at 25,000, really? Okay. And this one's at 15. All right, so there's a gap in between. It's all right. Singapore, I really want to pull this squadron out, but we haven't used these squadrons. Okay, I'm pulling these guys down. Let's go drop tanks, sweep. Up to Kota Baru. And next turn, we'll head over to Bangkok. I'm hoping one squadron down here will be enough. There just isn't any enemy activity. I'm keeping the P-40 Warhawks here because they're strafing so well. They're about the only thing that'll attack the damn E-boats. No new arrivals at Moulmein. There's a base. Okay, another base force arrived. This is the Royal Indian Army, I think. Okay, we'll get them on the road, send them down to Moulmein. Impal, no additional reinforcements. We've dropped 3 of the AKLs. They're going to update this turn. Good. But we just can't get any supplies up here. The supplies, aircraft-wise. As soon as these guys get fixed, we're sending them off. I need them in the war. Each of these aircraft carries 25 possible Air Cobras. So I'm going to leave the bomber trainers to the landlocked ones down in Seattle. There's a lot of bombers here. These guys are all landlocked. And I'll probably leave them for the... There's a bunch of Air Cobra squadrons here. I just haven't switched over. I might just convert these to something and bring them into the war. But right for now, I'll leave them there. I just don't know how many more squadrons. But the more I think of it, the more I will have to bring them into the war. I just don't have enough big squadrons of 25. And these guys are taking up a lot of space. So... Yeah, I just don't have, these are the only ones that are really landlocked. That's what, 1, 2, how many squadrons? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So that's what, 100, 250, 300, 300 fighters that we're training bomber pilots, which is fine. We're doing okay, but at the rate we're losing damn pilots, it's, I don't know, if we train 300, it's enough to keep up with our losses. Okay, over at Chittagong, We have fighter bombers. These are the Fulmar. We can't upgrade these because we can't seem to get 20,000 in here. So we're going to transfer them back to... Where are you, man? Come on. 15. Trying to get back to Calcutta. Oh, for God's sakes. Calcutta. Let's see. There's a fighter squadron here at Calcutta. The remnants. Oh, for... I can't seem to combine the damn things. If I hit disband here, the unit disappears. No. I want to get this one into this one, and it won't. There's nothing I can do to join them. There's nothing I can do. Oh, for God's sakes. Oh, for God's sakes. So I'm hoping that this one will repair. I can't disband it. I can't get rid of it. Pretty insane, isn't it? Pretty insane. Any other aircraft here? We have the Liberators. We're trying to recover these to send them off to reinforce Fusan. But now that we have 20,000 supplies here, I'm hoping that'll help them recover. I think that the low supply situation was hindering their recovery at Chittagong. Not positive, but I think so. Army continues to march up towards the trapped Akyab pocket. Quiet on Colombo. We have the transports just leaving. No convoy coming in from Bombay. They're just outside. They're just leaving the submarine danger zone, so I'll probably pull back the escorts. Just more convoy unloading at Karachi. Here's the changeover point. The escorts came out to meet them. Now we're coming to unload. Convoy forming up. Abadan. Regular reinforcement convoy for Karachi. No additional reinforcements at Aden. No reinforcements at Cape Town. Submarine check. Whoa! Lots of submarines hit. Okay. S-27's been bashed. Whoa! I thought the only enemy only got one hit on us, but that was clearly enough. Sargo took heavy damage. I'm glad these boats are so tough. And Trigger hit badly. Wow. Okay, those are the three. Checking for endurance. I think Guardfish is already coming back. Ah, Gurnard needs to be recalled. Tenosa, already coming back. Now we're checking for torpedoes. S-30, O-19, and S-27, along with others, fired a number of torpedoes, but they're all coming back, except S-27 has torpedoes, but she's damaged. We're coming home regardless, so no other submarines need to return. Quiet on Timor. We have something at Koh Phang, some unit, but I don't think it has any assault value, or else it would have recaptured Roti already. Enemy submarine near the Torres Strait. We're building up Ondata. Okay, up to 57% already. Other ones are racing past us. Bork. Up to 19%. These guys have gone over. Jeez, do I waste my time building them? They've already gone up to 16%. You know, could be a week and we'd have a full base here, but we don't need a full base here. We don't need a full damn base here. No, I'm going to stop these guys. Okay, stop. Everybody get in. Everyone get loaded. Get down. Stump down here. Set all to march. We're going to build up this one. This dock base into something. This one's actually worth more. We can build the port at the same time. Yeah, that's what we'll do. We have one more day to wait for the landing ship to be ready. We have... The Naval Aviation Regiment is ready. Sorry, the Aviation Regiment is ready, but I don't want to spend points. Even though it's only going to be 10 points to get out. I'll try to avoid it if I can. especially with this base force coming through. This one, not worth a hell of a lot, but at least we can get it off the island for free. Oh my god, the debacle over Guadalcanal. The farce never ends. All right, I've somehow forgotten an APD here. Ah! Oh, crap. Okay. Transport, fine. Let's set this one for Brisbane. Right, let's go here, just like the other one, before we drop in. Let's make sure we don't suck fuel from here. Thank you very much. Taking a look at Guadalcanal, we had over 20,000, and we're under 20,000 again. What the hell? Ugh! There's nobody here, and we're sucking. There's a wormhole, some kind of a black hole. Oh man, can't believe ya. Okay, we're gonna meet up with this guy. I don't want him traveling alone. So we're gonna backtrack to go grab our beloved fast destroyer transport. But does anyone else but me think that this is going to go down to zero? That the supply will suck out even when there's nothing, no base, nobody there? Oh, for the freaking heck. Okay, down at Christchurch. I think we're still unloading. Yeah, still unloading. Here, we have another ship in. Make sure we can dock it. Heck, we might as well put them together. It's not a big deal. It doesn't change anything, but we'll put them together. Also, another three ships in. Uh-oh, that's going to be too big for the dock. Oh, well. Yeah, these guys should be finished this turn. Or close to it. Close to it. Good job. Here. Slowly. Unloading it. Probably another week. 5 to 6 days, I estimate. Oh, didn't notice that the two cruisers are... Yes, the report. Two cruisers are finished repairing here. Okay. We're going to grab a couple of the... 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7. Hell, we'll take 8 of them. Hell, we'll take 8 and we'll take a couple of the... We'll take the Corvettes as well. Let's get them back up to Townsville. And we'll take the coastal route. Townsville, we seem to have... The enemy doesn't seem to be wanting to patrol over here, but he's inside the barrier reef, so I'm going to readapt some of these submarine, anti-submarine patrols. We'll try to sweep this area instead. Maybe we'll actually fight the enemy now. Yeah, I've made up my mind. I'm going to convert some of these air cobras. Yeah, they can go. So we're going to make the conversion to P-38 Echoes. Getting ready for making the calculation for the jump to light speed. Got all the fighters changed over to P-38 Echoes just so that we can make that great huge leap over to South to Korea without making a whole bunch of small little ones. Quiet on Panama, quiet on Pearl, convoy coming in, convoy going out. We have nothing here. Ships still under repair. The two Liberator squadrons are recovering their endurance before I send them onwards. We have a reinforcement. Alameda bringing it over to San Francisco. San Francisco, we've got a whole bunch of tankers going. I will send these tankers long range. We're going for Brisbane. We have another group of tankers loading up. I'm not going to wait around. No need to overload Brisbane, so I'll send two separate groups to... Yeah, that way we don't have too many tankers in at Brisbane. Transport-wise, these guys have loaded up, sending off to Guam. Pure transport, just supplies. Yeah, a couple of short a couple of points of supply of fuel, no big deal. Forming up another one. These are my smaller ones, the 3900s. That's fine. That's all we have left right now. Everything else is under refit. Sending a group of tenders. I should probably just change their name Does it matter? Oh no. I'll leave it as transport. I get the impression that if I change the name to support, they might, I'm not saying it's certain, they might not stay docked to the damn base. That's kind of weird that way. So I'll just leave it as transport. They're heading up to Iniwetok. These are my fast ones. My special forces unit. Yep, that's how I'm going to use my tenders. A lot of more ships coming back for refit and repair. We have right now 103 transports in refit. Good thing is, I think this is the last refit of the war for the transports. They don't need to. I don't have to worry about this hassle again now that we've done it once. I think that's all there is. So no more upgrades, no more refit for transports for the rest of the war, I hope. Unloading, still a few more, another batch coming through, unloading at Guam. Tankers, the AOs are trying to reload their holds to take care of the returning transports. The bow fighters, some of the bow fighters are here, are recovered and ready to go on Tinian. Time to clear out some space up here. These guys, the Corsairs, are recovering, so I'm not going to fly them off. There's still some fatigue to be shed first. Over at Hahajima. Okay, these Corsairs are ready to go. Let's strap. Oh, no tanks available. Good grief! Alright, how far can you go without any tanks? Oh, we can get to Shanghai! Holy crap! That's a hell of a range, alright! Up to Fusan you go! We'll rest up here at Fusan. Here's another Corsair 211 squadron. Okay. Transfer Fusan. Wow. Nice to have that. Incredible range. So we've got some room on Hahajima. Let's move this one up to Hahajima. We can't put everything on Chichijima. Okay, at Haha. Oh, crap. Did we just kill a pilot? We just killed a pilot, you miserable scum! Okay, let's divide the... Hold on. Rebuild. Let's grab a pilot. Do we want... No, I don't think we need an ace up here. We just need somebody up here. Somebody to hold the line. Okay, we'll take a 50. This is a bomber pilot. See, look, here's the bomber designation 55. And a bomber designation. Well, we'll take it as a training pilot then. So we got 24. This one's going to take a few days to get to arrive. We're at a fatigue level 5. Okay, we're going to go into the escort mode. We're going to go combat air patrol. Let's get out to 11. I will divide this so that we can try to maximize the number of reinforcements, replacements here. Oh, there aren't any more. Oh, shucks, that's right. That's it. That's all they wrote. What you got is what you got. Okay, so we're flying 50% here. These guys are flying 50% as well. So we've got some overlap, which is good, keeping a cushion over the bubble. Chichijima cannot handle all those aircraft. It's just a level 2 right now. Hahajima is level 1. It's even worse. So the next squadron will go up to Chichijima. But I thought I'd better have some kind of coverage over here. We've got some coverage on Iwo Jima with bow fighters. There's going to be a lot of aircraft in transit through this base. Yeah, we'll leave the Wildcats to defend the base itself. On the base, on Iwo Jima, we have pretty much repaired our high-value ships. They're all within 1 day of repair, and we're dropping off fuel from the AOs so that we can send them back for more at Guam. From Guam, we have some P-40 Echoes ready to, well, kind of, they're kind of fatigued, only 1 point, but I'm going to send them off. Let's get them up to Fusan. There we go. At Fusan, okay, we'll drop them down. I'm going to upgrade them to, I'm going to change them over to, we've got these P-40 Kilos. You know, hey, I've got the November ones. Why not use them, right? Why not use them? Let's use them. No, let's not. Let's go replacements. I will divide the unit. Let's try to maximize the number. All right. So we have fighters here. We have, where are they? The Novembers. So when we make a transfer to Japan, we'll have the maximum number of reserves possible. Let's reserve how many pilots. Whoa. Okay, these guys are trainer pilots. Not good enough to go into combat. No, let's break them out of here. Not sending these guys out. They need more training. Okay, what we are going to do is grab top level pilots, killers. We'll maximize. These are all 70 level pilots. Well trained, very capable. Oh, come on! Ah! Wrong button again! Freaking heck! Ah! Hate that. Thank God we, thank goodness we have so many of these damn things. Alright, so what have we got? 25? Okay. Add 8 more. God, I can't believe I hit that twice. Lots more 75s. Excellent quality pilots. Okay. Active. Turn them all on. By the time their planes are ready, we'll be ready to go into combat. On the southern front, I'm going to be standing down the pilots on Kavieng and Rabaul. Let's rebuild these guys. Rest them. God, my wrists are just killing me with these little... Missed it again. Alright, with these pilots have been... Oh, look at some experienced pilots. Look at that. Great pilots coming up. Most of these guys are trainers. We can... We'll exchange them before we send them into combat. So that these guys are standing down, we're probably going to evacuate the base as well, if we get a chance, here at the Aero Cobras. Rebuild, stand down. There's been no activity on the... from Rabaul. Check the pilots here. We've been using these guys as trainers again. See? Lots of qualified pilots. These guys, because they're 25s, we're standing them down in order to get them up into the war. We want the big squadrons. The Aussie squadrons of 12 and 16 pilots. These are 16 size. If these guys want to fly combat air patrol, sure. You're welcome to fly it over Rabaul. We might not even need one. I've been flying them here just because I've got the patrol squadron still flying out of this base for anti-submarine. But we've seen no enemy air activity at truck whatsoever. But it might be good to have one squadron over here. So I'll probably bring a squadron of Aero Cobras to Rabaul, if nothing else. A tiny one of the Aussie or Kiwi squadrons of 16. So we're going to free up the 25s. We need the heavier punch of the 25 aircraft squadrons in China, in Japan. Fighter sweep Kagoshima, wasted. Air attack, Kochi. Three aircraft for the loss of two. Air attack, Kochi. We're going to lose carriers this way. Air attack, Alor Star. 21 aircraft in. We lose five. We lose four. Enemy lose five. Terrible. Terrible. That's what happens when you pull out too many aircraft, I guess. Air attack, Kochi. One for one exchange. Not good. Air attack, Kochi. Two aircraft shot down for one loss. Wildcat. Another Wildcat lost for two enemy aircraft. Air attack, Kochi. Two more Kates destroyed. One more, six, seven aircraft shot down. One Warhawk lost. We got to get out of there before while we still have some pilots. Two more enemy aircraft shot down over Alor Star. Kochi, air attack. Air attack, Kochi. Whoa! What the hell was that? Must be a fighter sweep. Nicks, well, the Nicks are fighter bombers. Langkawi bombed. Three squads destroyed. Disabled, sorry. Langkawi bombed. Another squad disabled. One engineer destroyed. One support squad disabled. Air attack, Tanjung Pinang. Miss. Bombed again. Miss. Bombed a third time. Miss. Finally, we destroy one squad on Tanjung Pinang. All those bombs. Another non-combat squad destroyed Tanjung Pinang. Air attack, Kochi. Two bombers shot down for the loss of a Wildcat. God. The losses at Kochi are just abominable. And this is against the AI. Imagine against a human player. Well, I guess the AI has been hoarding all its aircraft. Ground combat near Taiwan, 35-1. Heavy Japanese casualties, but the enemy doesn't give up, kills six squads and five non-combat. Saori fires two torpedoes at an island freighter, hits. Night air raid, Kobe. One damage, but we're hitting the ships in port again. Great. That's what I always see. Oh, a miss. More ship hits. The Mitchells contribute. Mitchells strike again. Wow, I didn't think the light bombers had it in them. Three more hits at least. No, more than that. Six, seven hits. Great. Look at all those units dropping in, unloading at Kochi. I-16 is hit three times by depth charges. So repositioning them to the south has helped. Air attack from Tokyo at Kochi. 40 fighters up. 40 aircraft in. Few hundred fighters up. We only get four. He manages to get two of ours. Air attack, Kochi. Minneapolis under attack. She survives. Air attack, Kochi. Look at him coming from all directions. This one might get through. Kapahi is hit twice. Damn you! Air attack, Kochi. The Custer survives. Two Kates shot down. Another Kate out of eight shot down. We aren't killing them fast enough. It's just not enough. We've got to get more fighters up there. Chenango bombed. Got to keep track of these. Warhawk destroyed. Got to remember which ships need to rearm. Damn it. Oh, we have an air attack on a task force patrol. Minesweeper near. Finally! Finally! The Vengeance bomb. One hit and she sunk.